statements as a sector, which started 18 years ago, and it's one which is focused upon the youngest artists coming working with the youngest galleries. It's a really interesting place of discovery, and I think because of the nature of Art Basel, it's been a launching pad for many of the most famous artists today. And so what it means, if you come and you do an amazing show, an amazing performance at Art Basel in the statement sector, is that suddenly hundreds of people who might want to represent you, might want to collect your work, might want to curate you into biennials, will know you. So for us, it's a really important sector. I mean, there's, in a real sense, the future of the art world there.
Showing three large-scale photographs that are sort of take a less than traditional view of what a photograph is. Two of them are from a sort of family of photographs that are, I've been calling erased pictures, which where I use the clone stamp, which is a very common tool in Photoshop, that where you would sort of remove a blemish or something like this. I'm using it to sort of take all of the content out of still life pictures. And the third picture is a picture called Shoe, which is a picture of a handbag that's shaped like a shoe, that I've sort of continued the picturing of by drawing treads on the bottom. I'm really interested in the work still acting like photographs and sort of in presenting the world to you the way a photograph might, but instead of doing that in a very sort of straightforward, totally unencumbered way, I'm using all of these tools that are often used in photography in a very seamless, invisible way, in a very obvious way.
I'm showing a work by John Skoog called Redoubt. And John is a young filmmaker and artist. And this film is the last of a trilogy of films that are based on his native South Sweden.
I guess the quickest way to explain it is a film, a double portrait about a man and a house, a very specific house. And the man that built it was very afraid that Soviet would invade Sweden in the 40s, so he started reinforcing his house with concrete. But yeah, he didn't know how to build, so it became really weird, a weird but very special structure that still stands today, and the film somehow portrays that house and also gives a picture of him in a way.
It's a quite interesting place to show a piece like this, because this piece needs a high fluctuation of people, and we definitely have that here. It's a performance, and it consists of a five-channel audio installation, five headphones, each with a set of instructions, different but synchronized. So when people put on the headphones and follow the instruction, then the performance is acted out. One of the interesting aspects about this piece for me is that it's changing all the time. So even though the instructions run in a two-hour loop and it's repeating every second hours, the performance itself is changing constantly because new people are acting within it. The response so far has been pretty amazing. I have been very surprised by the level of commitment that people have shown. Like some random visitors are in the piece for hours and performing, and it has been really intense so far, I think.
Here at Art Basel, I have an installation called Lonely Loa Caride. So Loa Caride is actually the Latin name for a particular family of fish. These are a type of fish that are helping biologists make a very clear picture as to how evolution works, because how they've evolved is really hyper-specific to their niche habitats in the Amazon. However, the fish that are here actually do not have a species name. So these are fish that exist outside of that knowledge base. And here they're in these tanks, which are large enough to make them feel like their own environment, but they're on this set of bleachers as sort of spectators of the situation around here. Something like Art Basel is a very interesting moment where subjectivity becomes highly commodified. So here, the gap in the scientific knowledge of these fish is filled in by the commodification of the fish. And so there's sort of that conflict with each other, which is an interesting sort of parallel with what happens in a place like Art Basel, where artists contend with having their own sort of visions commodified.
I've had a lot of compliments, that it's a sort of a brave piece to bring to the fair, and there were definitely complications. Switzerland's a hard thing to get things into, especially if they're sort of wild caught tropical fish. So I felt a genuine appreciation that we did this and that people felt sort of pleased that there was something different, and there are a lot of different things, especially in this section of the fair, and but that they were excited that it was, even questioning what they thought was art.
This year we're showing an artist called Fumito Urabe. He's born in 1984, still quite young. He grew up in a temple, which his father was a monk. So much of his work is about Eastern philosophy. He believes that if you own something, it's only temporarily. And I think it shows in the work. He's always using found objects to make a drawing and a sculpture.
This hat is made by driftwood. I picked up on the beach. It's floating from maybe Southern Ireland or somewhere else. And the drawings use old paper from old books or old maps.
I have been working with Fumito for 4 years, and Basel is such a wonderful place to show new young artists, especially at the statements. And I really wanted people to like find Fumito and what he does in Tokyo. And many of the people that stopped by at the booth said that it's a little bit like Oasis. You know, you kind of contemplate looking at the work.